If you were constantly told that all you gotta do is just eat less if you want to lose weight, then it might explain your lack of any significant progress. And what might work for you is actually doing the opposite of eating less. Let me explain exactly what I mean. Now, to be perfectly clear, there is no doubt that the fundamental scientifically supported factor of weight loss is a negative balance of energy, or an energy deficit as measured by calories. As we've heard it 1,000 times, it comes down to calories in versus calories out. Now, depending on which supposed health and fitness guru you've been listening to, your feelings of calories might vary between calories are the end-all be-all to calories are a conspiracy spread by the food industry. Now, what I can say is that, although the most scientifically common weight loss factor is indeed calories, the types of food we eat also have a huge impact on weight loss outside of its calorie content. And that's where eating less tends to fail a good portion of people, because too often do we confuse the less in eating less as meaning less food and not just less calories. And when trying to eat less of the foods we enjoy, especially high-calorie, highly palatable foods that we develop strong preferences for, at a very young age, we run into major issues with things like hunger and appetite. Personally, I know exactly how this feels. Growing up, I had a wonderful mom who, unfortunately, was also a single parent working very long hours. So for many nights, me and my siblings were left figuring out dinner for ourselves, which ended up being a lot of fast food burgers and chicken nuggets. To this day, fast food cravings are still a biatch, but fortunately, over the years, I've learned to manage it quite well, and that's largely thanks to what I'm going to share with you now. Again, eating less is not enough. We also have to manage hunger and appetite. And one way we can do that, interestingly, is by eating more. Yeah, it sounds a little strange, but it's actually fairly simple. Again, the food we eat has an impact beyond just calories. And according to research, some foods are better than others in curbing our appetite and increasing satiety, or our feeling of fullness. These foods are usually 1, high volume, low calorie foods, which also tends to be high in fiber, like all of your delicious fruits and green vegetables, except kale, because kale is evil. And 2, they are foods that contain more of the profound, prolific, Picturefit approved macronutrient known as protein. Voluminous foods can fill us up more quickly, which have shown to act on certain hunger-related mechanisms like elevating levels of hunger-suppressing hormones and slowing down the process of digestion. Eating more protein has shown to also improve feelings of hunger, and even in one study, more protein led to a spontaneous reduction of 441 calories per day for 12 weeks. Essentially, subjects in the study ate fewer calories even though they had no intention of eating fewer calories or to even lose weight. So, if you feel like simply eating less just doesn't work for you, then instead try to eat more of things like proteins, fruits, and veggies first, minus kale. Protein supplements can help too, especially before your meals, which has shown to reduce overall food intake, but whole proteins are probably the best overall. To summarize, the Eat More approach focuses on managing appetite and hunger first. And if we do that, we don't have to actively force ourselves to eat less of our favorite high-calorie foods. We'll just naturally feel like eating less of them. And of course, that will lead to our main goal, and that is eating fewer calories overall. Now, if you do try this strategy, make sure you are indeed leaving room for the foods you enjoy and not just entirely replacing your diet with foods good for hunger and appetite. You want to avoid the same issue with eating less, and that's making your diet very hard to stick to. Moderation, as always, is key. Give it a shot, see what you think, and I hope it helps some of you as much as it helped me. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a voluminous thumbs up and share it with your appetite-loving friends. Subscribe for more and let me know what you think in the comments. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to get your protein.